The topic is converting equations from rectangular to cylindrical form. So let's do the first example. Convert the rectangular equation x equals 5 to cylindrical form. All right, so to convert from rectangular to cylindrical, we use these. So x is equal what? X is equal 5. So what I do, I'm going to replace. In other words, we can only have r's, theta's, and z's. So x, we can't have x. So we're going to replace it by r cosine theta. So r cosine theta equal 5. We usually solve for r, so r will be equal 5 over cosine theta, and we can rewrite this as far, 1 over cosine theta is just secant theta. Alright, so x equal 5, if this is a 5, it's this plane. I'm just drawing a portion of it, right? So what do we mean with r equal 5 secant? R is... comes from there to there, from the origin to the plane. All right, let's do the second example. Convert the rectangular equation y equal 2 to cylindrical form. Again, I'm going to replace y by r sine theta. So y equal 2. So r sine theta equal 2. So therefore, r equal 2 over sine theta. So r is equal 2 times 1 over sine theta is cosecant theta. So y equal 2, I'm going to draw a portion of it. Right, so again, my r equal 2 cosecant goes from the origin to the plane. All right, last one. I mean, not last one. Next one will be convert the rectangular equation z equal 4. Now remember, z is just equal z. Z is equal z, so nothing changed. So it's still the same. Z equal 4 is in a rectangular form and is also in cylindrical form. All right, next one. Convert the rectangular equation y equal 2x squared. Alright, y equal to x squared. Again, let me rewrite it here. I mean, y equal to x squared. First, let's graph it. If you graph it, it's going to be this parabola at z equals 0. Oops. No. Y equal 2x squared, and z could be anything. Yeah, this is actually y equal x squared would be that, right? And then you don't need this part, and then z could be anything, right? So let's just draw it so it looks better. Did I mess it up? Alright, so what do? Again, we only want thetas, z thetas, and r's. So what do? We replace again y by r sine theta. And then x is replaced by r cosine theta because it's squared. I gotta square this also. Now divide by r both sides. So I'll have sine theta is equal to r cosine theta. This means the R is equal sine theta over 2 cosine theta, cosine squared, right? So this is cosine squared, which means R equal 1/2. I'm gonna write the cosine as, it just looks better, as 1 cosine here, 1 cosine there. So this way I can say R equal 1/2 tangent theta secant theta. All right, let's do the next example. We need to convert the rectangular equation z equal x squared plus y squared. So, oops. All right, so it's a paraboloid, and so again, z equal x squared plus y squared, right? But remember, we know x squared plus y squared. We could plug in cosine, r cosine, r sine, but it'd be quicker to use the fact that r squared is equal to x squared plus y squared. So z is equal to r squared. That's it, that's easy. All right, next one, convert the rectangular equation z equals square root of x squared plus y squared. So that's a cone. So again, z is equal square root of x squared plus y squared. I know x squared plus y squared is equal r squared, which means z is equal r. Remember, r positive, it's not minus or plus r. We take r positive when we do cylindrical. All right, convert the rectangular. Next example, we have 2x plus 4y plus 2z equal 8. Now, x-intercept, so let's start with z-intercept will be 8 over 2, which is 4. X-intercept, same thing, 8 over 2, which is 4. And then y-intercept will be 8 over 4, which is 2. So here's a portion of the plane. Now we need to rewrite it in, let me write the formulas here. We know x is equal r cosine theta, y is equal r sine theta, and z we don't replace. Z is just z. So plug in r cosine theta here. There will be 2r cosine theta. Plug in r sine theta for y. 4r sine theta plus 2z. We don't do anything to z. Now what do? I need to, let's divide by 2. If we divide by 2, we'll get r cosine theta plus 2r sine theta plus z is equal 4. And we always write it as a when there's a z, we always solve for z. So z will be equal 4 minus r, move the r cosine theta plus 2r sine theta from the other side. This is done, but if you want to look, make it look nice, factor the r. This will be cosine theta plus 2 sine theta. All right, and that's it for this example.